Listen up, TPS fans. We're doing a giveaway. We're giving away either Madden 18 or NBA 2K18. Step one, subscribe to this YouTube channel. Step two, this video needs 5,000 likes. Once we reach 5,000 likes, we give away a copy of Madden 18 or NBA 2K18. Before we give away the game, you need to comment because we'll pick a random winner from the comments. The winners will be announced on the TPS Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram social media pages. So follow there as well. Good luck, TPSers. The 2017 NFL season should be one of the best in a long time. It's a boatload of young superstars on the rise, a handful of veterans looking to win a ring before they retire, and much more. But all fans really care about is how their teams will do. And we just may have an idea. I'm Daquan Young, and today we dive into our predictions for every NFL team's record in 2017. The Arizona Cardinals, 8-8. 2016 was a disaster year for the Cardinals after having Super Bowl aspirations. Carson Palmer and Larry Fitzgerald entered 2017 at the ages of 37 and 34. With an aging core and some key defensive players lost, Arizona won't be that much better in 2017. 8 wins is a reasonable expectation. The Atlanta Falcons, 10-6. Looking to avenge their historic Super Bowl 51 meltdown, Atlanta should benefit from Desmond Trufant's return. But Matt Ryan is bound to regress after losing offensive coordinator Mike Shanahan. With an ever-improving NFC South also to deal with, Atlanta won't be as dominant as last year, but they'll still be good. The Baltimore Ravens, 10-6. It's entirely possible that the Ravens own the best defense in 2017. Quarterback Joe Flacco should be better after more recovery from a torn ACL suffered in 2015. New receiver Jeremy Maclin is a huge weapon for Baltimore's offense as well. 10 wins and a playoff berth seem like safe bets. The Buffalo Bills, 8-8. The Bills are the opposite of a box of chocolates. We know what we're gonna get, mediocrity. LeSean McCoy is a stud, but Tyrod Taylor ain't the answer at quarterback. Until that defense recaptures his 2014 form, we can't be high on the Bills to emerge in 2017. Carolina Panthers, 9-7. The Panthers are a good candidate to bounce back. Cam Newton should return as a true MVP candidate. The only problem is their awful secondary, which truly missed Josh Norman last year. The offense will get them a winning record, but the defense will hold back double-digit Ws. The Chicago Bears, 4-12. Adding quarterback Mitch Trubisky in the draft was a nice win. But who's he gonna throw the ball to? Losing Alshon Jeffrey really, really hurt. This rebuilding project is far from over, and 2017 looks to be another year for the Bears to be in hibernation. The Cincinnati Bengals, 8-8. 2016 was a disastrous year for the Bengals, one that saw their 5-year playoff streak come to an end. With dysfunction all over the organization, the Bengals won't be able to rebound in 2017. The Cleveland Browns, 3-13. Myles Garrett will be a huge weapon on Cleveland and will give the suffering Browns fans something to celebrate. But with no playmakers on offense, Cleveland will have another letdown year. At least the first overall pick is a possibility. Again, the Dallas Cowboys, 11-5. Expect a slight regression from the NFC's top seed in 2016. Dak Prescott and Ezekiel Elliott will ensure Dallas defends its division title, but a leaky defense and improving NFC East division make things a bit tougher. They'll get 11 wins, but they ain't topping the 13 victories from 2016. Denver Broncos, 10-6. With arguably the best defense in the NFL, Denver's a sure bet to finish with a winning record. Unfortunately, a painfully awful offense is going to hold them back from adding Lombardi Trophy number 4. But Von Miller and the no-fly zone are good enough to bring home double-digit wins. The Detroit Lions, 6-10. Matthew Stafford can't be a one-man wrecking crew for much longer. The Lions' defense and ground game are way too leaky. With their NFC North foes set for better years in 2017, the Lions will fall back into the NFC basement. The Green Bay Packers, 12-4. With the best quarterback in the NFL, the Packers know Aaron Rodgers will get them double-digit wins. If the defense can avoid all of the injuries they suffered last year, they should be the top seed in the NFC. Green Bay is the team to beat in the conference heading into 2017, with great balance on both sides of the ball. The Houston Texans, 10-6. We all know what the Texans are. A good but not great team with an elite defense, but virtually no passing game. J.J. Watt and company will get them another AFC South title, but the offense will prevent them from being a championship contender. The Indianapolis Colts, 6-10. Andrew Luck is basically a one-man team with no offensive line and no defense at all. The Colts just let Luck get pummeled out there. Remember when they were a championship contender? Well, 2017 will be forgettable. Luck just can't do it on his own. The Jacksonville Jaguars, 5-11. We've waited a long time to see progress from the Jags. Not buying Blake Bortles to come back from a brutal 2016 season, the Jags will remain in the basement of the horrid AFC South. Kansas City Chiefs, 11-5. A true Super Bowl contender here, the Chiefs have racked up winning seasons in the last four seasons. With a decent offense, but a world-class secondary and pass rush, Kansas City is a force to be reckoned with. They'll get those 11 wins and fight hard for the AFC West title. The Los Angeles Chargers, 4-12. Phillip Rivers can be good all he wants, but the supporting cast around him is lackluster. The LA Chargers fans won't have such a nice welcoming in 2017 as the team figures to contend for the first overall pick. The Los Angeles Rams, 5-11. Firing Jeff Fisher was smart, but Jared Goff is far from ready to be a starting quarterback. Aaron Donald will have his beautiful talents wasted again. 5 wins, tops. Miami Dolphins, 7-9. Ryan Tannehill's injury hurts Miami. Jay Cutler and Matt Moore are not ideal options at quarterback. If Tannehill was healthy, Miami would be a playoff team, but they're pretty much screwed now. Still enough talent on defense will give them an acceptable 7 wins here. The Minnesota Vikings, 9-7. Losing Adrian Peterson will hurt. All eyes will be on Teddy Bridgewater as he returns from a torn ACL. The defense will carry Minnesota to 9 wins, but a lack of firepower on offense holds them off from winning the NFC North. The New England Patriots, 13-3. This team won Super Bowl 51 without Rob Gronkowski and Brandon Cooks. Now they have both. The Patriots have arguably the best offense and a top 5 secondary and will cruise to the AFC's top seed once again. The New Orleans Saints, 8-8. With 3 straight 7-9 seasons, the Saints have defined mediocrity. Give them one more win here, just cause we respect Drew Brees. New York Giants, 10-6. The G-men own one of the league's top defenses in all of last year. Eli Manning now has a third dangerous wide receiver in Brandon Marshall, which all sets up nicely for him to try to add one more championship ring. Show me Eli face. New York Jets, 3-13. The Jets were awful in 2016. And now that Darrell Revis is gone, also Brandon Marshall, the dark years of Jets football continues. Oakland Raiders, 12-4. The Raiders have all the pieces in place to reach 12 wins for the second straight season. Derek Carr runs an offensive juggernaut, and Khalil Mack is arguably the league's most dominant defensive player. Tack on a dozen here for the Raiders.
Yay, Raiders.
Philadelphia Eagles, 8-8. This is still a rebuilding year for the Eagles. Quarterback Carson Wentz still has to develop more, though the addition of receiver Alshon Jeffrey will help. The Eagles are getting close, but the young guys aren't quite ready for primetime. A 500 record is good, though. The Pittsburgh Steelers, 11-5. The Killer Bees offense will propel the Steelers to yet another division crown. Their once awful defense really took big strides in 2016, and the youth should only get better. The Steelers are the Patriots' biggest threat by far in the AFC. The San Francisco 49ers, 3-13. Remember when the 49ers used to be good with Jim Harbaugh and we could have sworn they'd fight for multiple championships? Fun times, huh? The Seattle Seahawks, 10-6. Age and injuries piled up on the Seahawks in 2016. It's kind of scary, but the great defense was picked on quite a bit last year. Russell Wilson can only withstand so many more hits before his body breaks. Seattle will win a super weak NFC West, but they're not contending for a top seed in the conference. The Tampa Bay Buccaneers, 10-6. 9 wins in 2016 was not a fluke. The Buccaneers are truly for real now. Jameis Winston and Mike Evans lead an explosive offense, and the Bucs have plenty of great talent on the defensive side of the ball. With Atlanta due for regression, the Bucs nab their first NFC South crown in 10 years. The Tennessee Titans, 9-7. 2016 was a progress year for Marcus Mariota and company. The Titans are getting oh so close to becoming Super Bowl contenders, but just give them one more year. The Washington Redskins. Kirk Cousins doesn't have many weapons around him now, with the exception of Jordan Reed. Throw in that super leaky defense, and the Redskins will be the worst team in the NFC East. Which NFL team do you think wins the most games in 2017? Join us in the comments below. If you liked this video and learned a thing or two, clicking the like button helps us out a ton, and we truly appreciate it. If this is your first time coming around on Total Pro Sports, though, subscribing is a great idea, because we put out videos like this every single day. But as always, thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys next time.